Welcome to ATV Television, the original television program for ATV enthusiasts and adventurers.
If you don't throw mud, you eat mud. ITP Mud Tires always keep you out front, moving forward through whatever Mother Nature throws at you. From the All Conditions Mud Light, the lightest mud tire on the market today, to the XTR, the world's first extreme terrain radial ATV tire that rides as good on the trail as it does in the mud. Make sure you always ride on ITP Mud Light Tires. Call for a free catalog or visit us at itptires.com.
The Outlander made a huge hit when it was first introduced, as it was filled with technology not seen before on an ATV. It had composite racks built into the bodywork, it had a single center position frame system, and trailing arm rear suspension. Now, it was a good machine, but needed polish. The folks at BRP have really been hard at work on the new 2007 Outlander, and it shows. The 400cc class of ATVs is often overlooked by the media and potential buyers because they just don't have the big bang. Hey, look at me, that the big bore ATVs do. And oftentimes they are overlooked because in an effort to keep the costs in check, they are less than full-featured ATVs. Well, the Outlander Max 400 should not be overlooked. Climbing on the Outlander Max 400, you're going to be amazed at how good it feels. Actually, for both the operator and the passenger. The seat is comfortable and the distance to the handlebars and the foot pegs is just right. The gauge pod houses a digital speedometer with either the odometer, trip timer, hour meter, or tachometer all selectable one at a time via a small black button. Now, also on the gauge face is the fuel gauge, the gear selection, four-wheel drive light, and several engine operation lights. The ignition key located below the gauge pod and just to the right alongside the 12-volt accessory outlet. On the right handlebar is the thumb throttle and the rocker switch to select between two-wheel drive and four-wheel drive. On the left handlebar is the hand lever that controls the braking to all four wheels. That same lever can also be ratchet locked to engage the parking brake. Now, although the headlights are controlled by a second position in the ignition key, there is a slide switch to choose between high or low beams. And there's also a yellow override button for more power in reverse, a green starter button, and the emergency kill switch. The liquid-cooled single overhead cam, four-valve, four-stroke, single-cylinder Rotax engine is fueled by a Mikuni carburetor. Now, this engine is perhaps the smoothest running engine in any ATV, and it's powerful as well, with the power being on par with most 500cc machines. The automatic transmission is a CVT unit with a sub-transmission allowing for high-range, low-range, neutral, reverse, and park, all selectable via a gated lever on the right side of the ATV. The shift gate and the feel and the precision of shifting between the gears has been greatly improved over the 06 model, losing most of its notchiness. The drive choices are two-wheel drive or four-wheel drive, and when in four-wheel drive, the front differential has what Can-Am calls Visco Lock, an automatic locking front differential that locks when it senses one front wheel spinning more than the other. Now, one item that helps lower the center of gravity and make the Outlander handle so well is that the 4.2-gallon fuel tank is mounted down low and behind the seat. Can-Am has made a huge departure from normal in the chassis and suspension on the Outlander. The frame, called SST for surrounding spar technology, is basically one big single center frame channel rather than a maze of round or square tubing. Now, this system not only keeps the mass of the ATV centered, but also works as a continuous skid plate running the length of the ATV. The other departure from normal is the rear suspension, called torsional trailing independent. Now, this is a pair of trailing arms that pivot on a torsional sway bar located in front of the rear wheels. This system allows the rear wheels to travel up and back rather than up and out like most typical A-arms do. Now, without this scrub, the tires track perfectly straight, not trying to steer the ATV as the suspension works. Now, you can go to Can-Am's website to see more on just how this works. Another big advantage with this system is that it has 75% fewer moving parts than a typical IRS. Now, unlike the Outlander 800, the 400 still makes do with a strut front suspension. Suspension travel is 7 inches up front and 8 inches in the rear with 5-way preload adjustable shocks in the rear. The brakes are a pair of inboard mounted discs up front and a single inboard disc in the rear. Both front and rear braking is controlled by a single hand lever with rear only braking operated by the foot pedal on the right floorboard. Although the brakes stop the ATV quickly, they could use much more feel to the controls. The tubular metal racks on the Outlander are some of the best, with the front rack capable of holding 100 pounds and the rear 200 pounds. Now, under the rear rack is a 5.3-gallon sized sealed storage compartment. The rear rack is rather small, but without the second seat, there's an additional storage box that can be quickly removed and replaced with a seat for riding a second person. And that is the magic of the Outlander Max. With the second seat in place, it can comfortably carry a second person without them interfering in the operation of the ATV. And even without the second person, the added length of the ATV makes it a far more stable machine than the shorter wheelbase standard ATV. And that alone is worth the additional length. The good, very smooth engine with incredible power for a 400cc engine. Great handling, easy to get on, get started, and get moving. Great ergonomic feel, and there's a parking brake and a park position in the transmission. The bad? Single lever braking with little feel and no feel from the rear brake pedal. The bottom line, except for the brakes, this ATV could be one of the absolute best ATVs on the market today. And if the brakes don't bother you, then guess what? I guess it is.
You want to ride the Screaming Aardvark Trail this weekend?
You're on! I gotta get some gear though.
Yeah, me too. Hey, I'll see you then. Oh, cool.
What?
Yeah, these are shot. So if I add the boots, shipping's free?
The shipping's free.
Excellent.
Ah, yes.
There's a package there.
Oh, yeah! My boots! Nice! You look good.
Shut up.
Get ready the easy way with Rocky Mountain.
Hey, excuse me. Would you mind jumping on the back? I want to see how it feels. Thanks.
Hon, I'm sorry I'm late. I was just getting my glasses.
This is just plain wrong.
What?
The Outlander Max easily converts from 1 to 2 passenger mode. Now with up to 6 times the warranty of the competition. A full 3 years.
With the handles. Yeah, it's more comfortable.